Internal rate of return, or most commonly referred to as IRR, is a discount rate used for measuring the profitability of potential investments. The effective rate of return makes the net present value of all cash flows from an investment equal to zero. Pay close attention to the fact that all cash flows must be included in the calculation of IRR, positive and negative ones. Let's use the example we saw in our previous lecture to illustrate IRR and how it can be applied. I will directly use Excel's IRR function. To do that, I will select the values for all cash flows in our investment and will press Enter. The result we obtained is 5%. But what does it mean precisely? Well, the present values we have from our previous lecture were all calculated at 10%. IRR calculates the rate I would have had if the NPV was equal to zero, if the sum of the present values for the periods from 1 to 5 was equal to the initial investment, in this case, 500. Instead, the sum of the present value of the 5 cash flows is equal to 433, which is less than 500. Now, let me redo the calculation by using the IRR figure we obtained here. Okay, the structure of the formula is the same, discounting a cash flow value at 1 plus the internal rate of return to the power of the number of the period. Good. I will paste the formula to the right. Wonderful. I told you, it adds up to 500. Lovely. So what would be the financial interpretation of this calculation? Would I consider this a worthy investment if my cost of financing is 10%? No, because 5% is smaller than 10%. Therefore, if we carry on with this project, we'll obtain returns that cannot cover its cost of financing. Just think of these two scenarios. I can go to a bank and invest my money at 10%, or I can invest my money here at 5%. Evidently, I will make more from investing my money in the bank. So, if I invest here, I will practically lose money. Therefore, as long as the internal rate of return is lower than an alternative investment I can choose, I should not invest. If the internal rate is higher than the interest rate, I should invest. Both NPV and IRR are used in the world of finance for assessing the potential profitability of projects. Often, practitioners calculate both NPV and IRR before making a decision.